Okay, so last property that we started in the last session is inverse Laplace by derivative. Inverse Laplace by derivative, that is a property we started. When we use this property, derivative property, whenever our fs involves either logarithm, tan inverse or cot inverse function. Okay, so start with the given function as fs and try to find its inverse Laplace. Start. So we can observe, first of all, this 1 by 2 is a constant. This 1 by 2 is a constant. We can keep as it is. There is no need to find the Laplace of that. At the end, we can keep 1 by 2 outside also. Or you can take it there also. It's not a problem. So I will take fs is equal to, let f of s is equal to log of 1 minus a square upon a square only. Because that constant doesn't matter, like linearity property, 1 by 2 will come outside. Okay. So we can take it like the log of s square minus a square, cross multiplied just. And let me write this in the form of log of s square minus a square minus log of s square. So this one is given fs. Okay, 1 by 2 is only, we'll keep it at the end. Now we can differentiate because derivative becomes so simple. This gives us, what is the value for f dashes, anyone? It's a 1 upon s square minus a square into derivative of that bracket, that's a 2s, minus 1 upon derivative log, that is 1 upon s square into derivative of that, that is again a 2s there. So this can be simplified like this. It's a 2s upon s square minus a square minus 2 by s, or 2 I will take common, minus 1 by s, minus 1 by s. Can anyone tell me next step? What should be done? We have the value for f dashes and we want pardon?
S plus a square is equal to cos ax. Not and correct. 1 by s is equal to t.
Not correct, not correct. It is not cos.
Cos hyperbolic.
Very good. That is cos hyperbolic now. So taking inverse Laplace on both sides, L inverse of f dashes is a minus t into f of t. L inverse of f dashes is a minus t into f of t, while RHS is a 2 times, this one is a cos hyperbolic at. Cos hyperbolic at minus 1, that's 1. Therefore, actually it's better you keep 1 by 2 also, because right now what happens, we write f of t as the answer. So let I write 1 by 2 from beginning only. So this is 1 by 2 here I am writing. So this one is 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 is a common and we keep the bracket like this. So there is 1 by 2 and this is the bracket. So that 2 gets cancelled there and there is no need of that writing 2 later on. After this, there is no 2. So just this one is our, and we get the answer, the final step. What should be f of t then? 1 minus cos hyperbolic at. It is not cos at, remember. This is the first time we come across that hyperbolic function, and that's the answer. So what we done? We assume that our f of s is 1 by 2 times log of 1 minus a square by a square. Just use the properties of logarithm, derivative, and at the end, inverse Laplace. If you have the doubt, yes, you can ask. Any doubt? Are you completed this? If you completed, tell me. We'll move to the one last example on this type. Okay, done. Very good. So, one more question is here. Find the inverse Laplace of 1 upon s into cot inverse of s minus 2 upon 3. Now, in previous question, there is 1 by 2, constant. Yes, constant we can keep as it is. But now, if we take entire this function as fs, the derivative becomes so complicated. Because 1 by s is a function of s, cot inverse is also a function of s. You have to use a product rule for differentiation, and that becomes too complicated. So, instead, there is one more property of inverse Laplace that we are going to use it at the end. It is known as a division by s property, because 1 by s is there. It is just like divided by s. So, we are going to use the division by s property at the end. So, just ignore that 1 by s and take the remaining as fs. So, let me start fs as f of s as cot inverse of s minus 2 upon 3. So, what about f dashes then? Yes, tell me the derivative. Tell me the derivative of this. Not getting answer from anyone. What is the derivative of cot inverse? How much time you are taking, huh?
Minus 1 by 1.
Okay,
1
good.
Plus s minus 2.
Minus 1 upon 1 plus s minus 2 upon 3. That bracket square into the derivative of a bracket, that is into derivative of s minus 2 upon 3 is 1 by 3, na? So this way. Now a small simplification will do it. We can observe that 3 can be taken in the numerator. This 3 square, actually 9 comes in the, so 1 3 gets cancelled. It's a minus 3. Minus 3 upon 1 plus s minus 2 bracket square. It is not 1 plus again, it is a 9 plus. Is it okay? Any doubt up to here? No doubt. Okay. Now we can take inverse Laplace. Therefore, taking inverse Laplace. On both side, this gives us L inverse of f dashes is a minus t into f of t, t into f of t. And now, what about the L inverse of this part? Yes, anyone? What is the L inverse of the RHS? Quick. I want answer. This s minus 2 indicates it's a shifting, na? Every s is in the form of s minus 2 only here. So it is e raised to 2t into L inverse of that minus 3 upon 9 plus s square, or s square plus 9. So I will say minus e raised to 2t. This minus sign also come out, this minus sign. And 3 upon s square plus 9 is a sine of 3t. So what we got here, thus f of t equal to e raised to 2t sine 3t divided by t. Up to here, we just completed the L inverse of this cot inverse. There is 1 by s also. So this is nothing but that f of t is nothing but this is L inverse of fs. L inverse of fs is f of t. and that is e raised to 2t sin 3t divided by t. So this is the L inverse of fs, that is f of t. Now we want that 1 by s, fs upon s. Actually we want L inverse of fs, because this is our fs, this part is our fs, and we want L inverse of fs upon s, that is 1 by s we want there. So by division by s property, can anyone tell me what should be the RHS? Division by s property, or when we divide by s in Laplace. Laplace, when we divide by s. When we divide by s, quick. I think half of the students are just log in there. They are not physically, mentally there at the present in front of the screen. Is that? I ask one question. When we divide by s in a Laplace, when we take a Laplace of integral, is that Laplace of integral is a division by s? So here we have to do the opposite thing. So hence, last step I will say, L inverse of fs upon s is the integral 0 to t f of t dt, that is e raised to 2t. Okay, I will write down, I will just use a different ink because it's mixture then. So final answer, I will write it here. It's an integral 0 to t e raised to 2t psi 3t upon t dt. And that's the end of the question. We got L inverse of, and the interesting part is here, answer is in the form of integration. Some of the student try to integrate it, but it's not possible. Remember, you have to keep that as it is. Okay, as we are calculating the Laplaces of integral, the inverse Laplaces of function of s can be the integral. Okay, so answer of inverse Laplaces can be in the integral form itself, no need to evaluate. Okay, so this is one interesting thing that you should remember. Otherwise, by mistake also don't try to evaluate it. That's the end of the question. So question is divided in two parts, so it's rarely asked this question. So what you have to do it, the first you have to focus only on this part where cot inverse is involved. So first we find the inverse Laplaces of that cot inverse function, and at the end we use a division by s property. So the last step is by division by s property, the answer is the integral 0 to t. The limits again important, it should be 0 to t there. Okay, so that about your derivative. So how many properties we used? Yes, anyone? How many properties we used actually to find the inverse Laplaces? Total, how many properties we used? Whatever the numericals we finished, near about 10-12 examples we finished in inverse Laplace, how many properties we used? Okay, I got answer as a 5 there. 5 is not correct again. Neil, actually we use only 4 properties. I will tell you the name. The first one is linearity property for inverse Laplace. Second is a first shifting property for inverse Laplace. Third one is inverse Laplace by derivative property, and last fourth property just here we used, and that is division by s property. So only 4 properties we used, and that are enough to solve any example here. Okay, generally other properties are not used or not that much useful for getting the inverse Laplaces. Yes, there are the questions on that also, but not important. Okay, not required also. Okay, so I will move to the second last article of inverse Laplace. There are 2 articles we left in inverse Laplace. The one is